Hey, it's Cobra here at MaddenGuides.com, and for this Madden NFL 23 defensive plays video breakdown, going to take a look at the 46 normal cover one hole A-gap blitz. And I know what you guys are thinking. You're thinking, Cobra, there is nobody blitzing through the A-gap, and you would be absolutely right. However, with one adjustment, you can get some instant A-gap heat that's pretty darn quick. In just over 2 seconds, you can probably get to the quarterback pretty darn quick. And we're going to go ahead and take a look at it. So let's go ahead and take a look at the play diagram as you look at your screen. Again, this is the 46 normal cover one hole. As you can see, with this particular defense, you got one defender playing the deep middle, and then you also got one defender playing the hook zone, and then you've got five defenders in man coverage. As far as the playbooks are concerned, as you look at it, it's from these three playbooks, the 46, the Bengals, the Eagles playbook. For the breakdown, we're going to go ahead and use the 46 playbook. Here is what the 46 normal cover one hole defense assignments look like by default. And as you can see on your screen here, you've got two defenders that are dropping back into zone coverage. And here's those two defenders as you look at your screen. You've got this guy right here, which is the free safety. He drops over the deep middle. And then you're also going to have this guy right here, which is the middle linebacker. He drops back in a three receiver hook zone as you look at your screen. And then you're going to have five defenders that are in man coverage. As you look at it, you can see those are the five defenders as far as the defense is concerned, as far as man coverage. As far as the pre-snap adjustments, the first thing you want to do is before you even get to the field is go ahead and go into the defensive coaching adjustments. So I'm going to go there right now, go into that. And what you want to set is this right here. Now, I've shown this before in some of the other blitz setups I've shown as far as the manual pass rush. And this is one of them right here where you set the zone drop hooks to zero. So make sure you do that. And let's go ahead and get back on the field here. We're going to go ahead and run this again from the 46 normal cover one hole. As far as from the offensive side of things, we're running this from the gun bunch, offset, speed dig. And the running back is running a delayed option route. So I want to point that out to you. Now, as far as the setup is concerned, you're just going to go ahead and spread the defensive line out. The next thing is you want to go ahead and call QB contain. Now, that's optional. I prefer to do it to prevent the quarterback from rolling out. Some of you other people out there, some of you other guys may not want to do that. The next thing you want to do is call press and man coverage. Again, this is optional. You do not have to do this, but I prefer to slow those receivers. I feel like I can get to the quarterback quick enough before they get off the jam. All right. Now, the rest of the setup here is you just want to take control of this guy right here. Now, for that, you guys have watched the 46 normal inside blitz that I just recently showed. You'll remember, right, that I actually brought him up in this area here. And then what would happen is this guy right here, which is going to be Parsons, would actually shoot through the A-gap. Now, what I would do with Parsons, if you remember in that blitz setup I showed, let's go ahead and get back over to him. I would bring him up and then release him and then allow him to get a little bit closer. And then I would bring Vander Esch up in this area here, and we'd engage the center. Such as this, I would try to engage the center right here, and then I would drop him back and go ahead and take away the short to mid middle of the field as far as pass routes are concerned. Well, on this one, I'm not going to do that. I'm actually going to manually pass rush him. But the cool thing is with this setup is now rather than having a defender defending the short to mid middle of the field, I have a defender defending the deep middle of the field. So you basically do a trade-off with this. You still kind of get the same look. You got two different defenses with basically the same look, but with two types of different coverages. So I want to point that out to you. All right, the next thing you want to do is you don't bring him there, though. The only difference is between the 46 normal inside blitz that I showed in the cover one hole is I need to bring him over to this area here and hot route him on a mid read as you look at your screen. So when the ball is snapped, what's going to happen is he's going to drift over this direction here, and it's at that point that I'm going to manually rush him up through the A-gap and apply pressure on the quarterback. Let's go ahead and run this, and then we'll get an instant replay, and I'll talk about a little bit more as far as what happens with this particular play, and I'll show you why it's so effective as far as bringing that A-gap pressure. And right there, you can see I get to the quarterback pretty quickly. So that's the setup. It does a pretty nice job as far as bringing that A-gap pressure while providing some decent pass coverage deep, plus you got those other five defenders in man coverage. Now that we're in instant replay mode, I can really show you how this play works as far as the X and O's are concerned here. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. The first guy I want to look at happens to be the center. And this is the guy that I really have to get occupied somehow or try to get past. Now, one of the things that I like to do is not slant the defensive line out. So if you remember right, I went ahead and spread the defensive line out. but I did not slant the defensive line out. So if I were to slant the defensive line out, this guy right here, which is going to be this weak side defensive tackle, would have went in this direction here. And then this other guy, this strong side defensive tackle, would have done the same thing, plus those outside guys. But remember, we got the outside guys in QB contained. But those two guys would have slant to the outside. But without doing any of that type of stuff, what they're going to do is they're going to go to the inside here. And the idea of this is, I know that the left guard is going to go ahead and block the weak side defensive tackle. I guarantee that. What I'm also hoping for is that I can get this guy, the center, to look the block into this direction. Now, that doesn't always happen. On occasion, you might see him do it. If he does that, it makes the blitz even that much more effective, because there's going to be a bigger gap that you can shoot through. If he doesn't do that, you can still get through with the middle linebacker, and you're going to see that here in just a second as we continue to go through this instant replay. So that's what you're looking for with that as far as the setup is concerned. You're really wanting to get the center out. So with that said, I'm going to go ahead and just continue on with this. So here's the middle linebacker. Remember, we put him into a mid zone. Now, I will tell you this. You can only put the inside linebackers in a mid zone. That meaning the right inside linebacker, left inside linebacker, middle linebacker. They are the only defenders that you can put into a mid zone as far as hot routes are concerned. So just remember that. And I feel like the mid zone does the best of any of them as far as bringing pressure on a quarterback. Now, I'm going to continue on with this as we go through here. So as you watch this, as I go through some frame rates here, or go, you know, as far as going through some frames here, frame by frame, if you look at this, you're going to notice right off the bat, I don't get what I'm really looking for right here. I don't get this guy to block to the left and look to go ahead and block him, at least initially. Instead, he does look to go ahead and block this guy. Now, I still believe a lot of times in this game, I still think the offensive line before the snap, the AI knows that these guys are rushing or not, or at least has a not pretty good idea. I can't confirm that, but that's just my gut feeling. But anyway, he is looking to block over in that direction. You can clearly see that. He's looking to block towards the middle linebacker. But as you watch, he's actually at some point not going to look to block anymore. Now, he is looking to block the weak side defensive tackle. And as soon as I see that, that's what gives me the cue that I can go ahead and manually rush this guy and try to get away from him by going this direction here. In this case, I'm going to have to go this direction. Now, sometimes if he, right when the ball is snapped, if he goes over and tries to block the weak side defensive tackle, then I don't have to take that blitz angle. I can actually go straight out to the quarterback instead and go that direction. In this case, I have to kind of take a little bit of an angle to get around him. But right there, you can see how I got around him. Now I know I got the quarterback. At this point, I'm pressing down that speed burst button, and I'm heading towards the quarterback, such as you see on your screen right there. So that's kind of important with the setup, is that you really want to watch and see what that center does as soon as the ball snaps. See what he does. If he goes automatically goes and blocks that weak side defense tackle, you know you got it. If he doesn't, then you kind of got to wait to see what happens with that. But as far as that goes, that's what how this play works. So we can definitely get some pressure on the quarterback pretty consistently with this one. And you can see one other thing I want to point out here as the video is going through, as we're going through these frames. As you look at it, against this particular play that we're showing here, this particular receiver is open. Now, your opponent could try to throw a bullet pass and try to hit that, and he may or he may not. I mean, maybe that safety will break on it. Maybe this free safety who's playing that deep middle, maybe he'll break fast enough and take that away. I don't know, but that guy is open. Really the only one that's really open as far as with this play, but you're hoping you get to the quarterback pretty quick as far as getting it. Matter of fact, let's go into the ticker right here and take a look at that, and I'm going to go ahead and show you how fast. Let's go ahead and reset this. I'm going to go ahead and show, when I did this play earlier, it ended up getting to the quarterback within just under 2 seconds, but that's not always going to be the case either. Let's go ahead and do this, go ahead and run the ticker, and we'll see what happens here as far as getting to the quarterback right there. See right there, it almost took me almost over two and a half seconds to get to him. So, and that's only because I had to slant to the outside on this. Let's do it one more time and see if we get a little different there, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be about the same time. So it's right around between 2.6, 2.7 as far as getting to the quarterback. Still fairly quick blitz. But let's go ahead and reset it up again and do the same thing. So let's go ahead and spread the defensive line out. QB contained. Go ahead and call the press man coverage. Take control of this guy here and see what we get here. See if we get that. Let's see if we get that center to look the block towards the left there and go after that weak side defensive tackle. Like I said, he doesn't always do it. But right there, we got him that time. We got to the quarterback. That might be a little quicker than what I just showed earlier. Let's go back in the instant replay and take a look at that and see what happens with that as far as what the ticker goes. So let's go ahead and reset the ticker again and let's see what we get here. So just a little bit faster, about 0.4 seconds faster. So right at 2.3. So you can definitely get to the quarterback pretty quick with this as far as bringing pressure on the quarterback. And it's something I really wanted to show because you can mix this in with the 46 normal inside blitz and really try to confuse your opponent with this particular play that I feel like does a pretty nice job because now you got coverage over the top versus under the middle. So keep in mind too, you know, you can go ahead and run this just like this, just like I did the setup already before. And what you can do here is rather than rushing him, you could just go ahead and drop him back into coverage to try to fool your opponent that way. So there's some different things you could work off with this particular blitz setup. Now, I'm going to show you something else here. Someone pointed out to me before and asked me, why do I just got to hot route these guys or go into the coaching adjustments and set this to this? Well, I'm going to go ahead and put this to default. So let's go back into the zone drops. Now I'm going to show you why I feel like this works better. Let's go ahead and go back into the same place. Go ahead and turn the ticker back off here. And we'll go ahead and show you what will happen with this. So let's turn the ticker off and we'll go back in there. I want to show you what will happen with this because that was a good question. And I want to go ahead and show that to you guys. So there's a setup as you look at it. And then I'm going to go ahead and bring him in here. Now this time I'm just going to leave him in the three receiver hook. I'm not even going to put him in a mid zone. I'm just going to go with this. And I'm going to show you that you can get in there, but you may not get in there all the time. You may get them getting blocked, but you can still run that, but you're going to find that it's a little bit slower than if you weren't to do that. So that's kind of the reason I like to do that. Now, some of you might find it might be a little bit different for you, but for me, I like to do it. I actually got blocked that time. I just feel like I get more blocked more often or not if I do it this way than I would if I didn't do that way. So that's kind of the reason I like to put those into zero hook zones. Plus, what will happen is, when that ball is snapped, he actually takes on his own. He actually goes this direction for me. I don't even have to control him. He just goes this direction. If he's in that mid zone and I got those hook zones turned off or turned to zero or set to zero, he goes in this direction on his own. That's the other thing I like about this. So let's go ahead and put him in the mid zone, a middle read this time. So this time it's the mid read. Now you can try to do this. You can go ahead and delay it and then try to go after the quarterback. But again, he gets blocked. So that's the reason that I really don't. That's the reason I really don't like doing it this way, because I don't feel like I get as consistent as I would if I set the hook zones to zero. Now, keep in mind, let's go back here one more time here. Let's run it one more time as you look at it. And again, I got blocked. So it just doesn't work as well to me as it would if you were to set your hook zones into zero. Let's go back into it real quick here, back into hook zones. Now, keep this in mind. For you guys that don't know this, most of you guys probably already know this. When you set these to zero, it doesn't mean they're always going to be set to zero. You can come out, and when you come out to the thing here, maybe you don't want to run that blitz and you'd rather just have them drop back like they're supposed to. You can just go ahead and hit the reset button, and now he's not going to do that. He's going to drop back to normal def. Well, watch what happens here when I snap the ball. See, he drops back to normal def. Whereas if I didn't do the reset, then he wouldn't have done that. For example, here, I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. I'll stay on the weak side defensive tackle. Go ahead and watch this guy again. Watch this middle linebacker. Now, I didn't do anything as far as reset. Watch what he does. See, he comes up near the line of scrimmage. So that's the difference there. So you can always go ahead and reset it and basically just turn that off by resetting the defense whenever you come on the field if you don't want to run that. So I'm going to run this one more time, guys. We'll get out of this video breakdown. I really wanted to go through the X's and O's behind this one and really show you guys the why this one works and how it works so you guys get an idea. And I hope you guys can mix this one in with the 46 normal inside blitz because it works as well. And finally, I've got a couple other blitzes here. We're going to be doing a zone blitz next that's going to be very similar to this that's going to bring some pressure on the quarterback as well. We'll do that one later in the week. So let's go ahead and run this one more time and we'll get out of the video breakdown. And I hope that you guys enjoyed the video breakdown here as far as getting to the quarterback, as far as showing you how to get to the quarterback rather quickly. So, again, guys, there's your setup. Very simple to do. Hopefully, this is a defense you guys can definitely add to your arsenal for you guys who run the 46 normal. It's not, I don't understand why guys aren't running this more, because I guess maybe there's, you know, everybody wants to go to the nickel and the 3-3-5 and all that good stuff. But the 46 normal, especially that speed package, it's still pretty effective in the game this year. Unfortunately, it's only in 3 playbooks. So, guys, hope you guys enjoyed the video breakdown. I appreciate it. Don't forget to hit that like button or hit the, post a comment. You know, whatever, hit that thumb button. You know, do something for me. Help me out. You know, check out the website. and just let other guys know that, hey, Kroeber's still breaking down plays after 20 some years of doing this, and I still enjoy doing it for you guys.